Signs of the tough economy are all over, Laura.
All over. That's right, Larry. You'll find more signs popping up on street corners advertising home businesses like childcare.
Now, some may think a home daycare is an easy startup business, but Kelly Ackerman explains why some childcare experts are cautioning buyer beware.
You know, if it seems there are more home childcare listings popping up in your neighborhood, it's probably not your imagination. Health officials tell us there do seem to be a lot more pop-up businesses during an economy like this, but they say that's why it's more important than ever that you do your homework when you're looking for quality childcare.
Just hold on tight.
Diane Meyer's been providing childcare in her home for 4 years, but has spent her entire career working with children, first as a school teacher. It was not an overnight business. She took courses, studied the state laws, and got her business licensed with the state of Kansas.
I think it's a high and a noble calling to do child care in your home. I think it's a special thing. I don't think everybody can do it. And I don't think you can just hang a shingle and be good at your game.
Good job.
But Meyer and other home child care providers who meet regularly are seeing more of that. New competition from pop-up home daycares that are offering cheaper services.
Every one of them has said, over the years, I've always had a waiting list. And at this point in time, no one has a waiting list. That's a very odd thing.
Shelley Webb with the Johnson County Health Department is not surprised to see a spike in pop-up daycare businesses in these tough economic times. She's seen it before.
I agree with the economy, you need to really think about these things as a parent and not just place your child someplace that someone just pops up a sign that you need to go through the right steps to locate a qualified care provider.
Webb encourages all parents to look beyond just price and convenience. Number one, ask if it's registered or licensed. If it's licensed like this home daycare, it gets a mandatory on-site inspection every year. To be registered, a provider has to take classes and file paperwork, but there's no regular inspection. Parents should consider that.
I believe that parents like that, to know that somebody is coming in and helping make sure their kids are safe. And even in today's economy, that's not something that you want to cut cost on.
And she strongly advises dropping in unannounced to any daycare you're considering to get a true picture of what goes on.
Now, requirements for licensing or registering a child care, that varies some from state to state, sometimes even from city to city. We have information about all that on our website, KMBC.com, along with referral agencies that can tell you if a child care is licensed or registered. I'm Kelly Eckerman. Back to you.